Now, the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Matt Ritter.
And one of the first areas hit by the flash flooding, of course, was the Waitrose City. But looking live over York right now, live sky cam, totally different. Mostly sunny skies for the time being. A little bit of haze. Clouds start building later on this afternoon. There could be an isolated shower or a thunder shower with the first of a couple of cold fronts going through. That's going to bring us basically, again, just a mixture of clouds and sunshine today. And eventually, we'll see maybe a thunder shower here or there pick up during the morning hours. Let's go back to that York sky cam for a second and take a look at that and see if there's any of those clouds starting to build across some of the northern locations. And so far, so good. A little bit of a light breeze out there. And for the time being, that's the way it's going to stay. Basically, for the rest of the afternoon, we're going to start to see partly sunny skies, warm and sticky, with an isolated shower or a thunder shower. Temperatures will be 82 to around 86. And then again, a chance of an isolated thunder shower through this evening, partly sunny, warm and sticky. Temperatures in the 70s, and then things will be falling down into the lower 60s for overnight lows, becoming cloudy with a chance for some more showers arriving. Winds will be light out of the west-southwest at around 5 to 15 miles per hour. Right now, the live Super Doppler 8 radar network is all clear of precipitation. There were a couple of thunderstorms in the northwest late last night and early this morning. They fell apart, and generally we'll just watch for a couple popping up during the afternoon. 75 now in the capital, 80 degrees in York. Dew points are not oppressive, but they are kind of sticky. They're in the mid-60s. These numbers are going to be going down into the 30s and the 40s over the next couple of days, so we are really going to be drying out the atmosphere, but we're going to be cooling it down as well. 75, mostly sunny now. Dew points 65, relative humidity at 71%. So the pattern change is a couple of troughs of low pressure dips, if you will, in the jet stream coming straight down from Canada. The leading edge are the couple of cold fronts going through. One over us right now, kind of falling apart. High pressure moving away. This second front is going to be the much stronger one. It's going to slow down. It's going to catch up to all this. A lot of the rain is going to be falling on the other side of the front. So once we really start to get in the shower activity later on tonight, temperatures will drop and they'll have trouble recovering during the day tomorrow. So our predictor is showing the trend, the increasing shower threat as we go through the late evening and overnight hours. A lot of it will be coming to an end during the day tomorrow, but then temperatures will have trouble recovering because of the cool northwesterly winds. Front kind of bogs down just to the south a little bit. Some scattered showers could last across the Delmarva Peninsula all the way into the weekend, but we should be mostly dry. Temperatures fall down into the lower 60s tonight, barely getting to near 70 degrees tomorrow. Look at that contrast in temperatures tomorrow afternoon. And again, that cooler air comes all the way down through the valley, and it looks like we may be dipping down into the 40s for lows by Friday morning. So here's your 7-day forecast, only in the upper 60s for highs tomorrow. Showers ending and fall-like for a couple of days. Friday into Saturday, high temperatures only in the 60s, 72. Back to near seasonable temperatures by the end of the weekend. And yeah, this time last week, Susan, we meteorologists, we just could not believe what we were seeing.
Yeah, really. Unprecedented.
Unbelievable.
Yeah. All right. Thanks, Matt.